Deep in the mountains of Yunnan province, Gongshan County is one of the most remote places in China. A life of hardship used to be the norm here, especially for sick people, causing them to suffer in silence.
Quiet!
Thanks to a team of dedicated medics, however, there's hope for a cure to this situation. I'm on my way to Gongshan, where I'll experience the life of rural doctors, learn about how poverty and health are connected, and see what's being done to improve the healthcare situation. Pengdang, which is the local hospital here in the town.
Hi, 然后就是给他测血压，又对症处理，一般都是这边。一开始来说就100种药物，我就觉得很不可思议。这个山区呢，它存在一个问题，就是体现一个缺医少药，交通不便。临时留把它全部堵了，他发全部堵了，你还真的一个礼拜、两个礼拜出不去。I'm
going to get my own lab coat.
简单的做一个基础培训，然后你就可以上岗了。好。对，就是这样。好。培训一下测血压，还有血糖，这个袖带要放在肘上，这个就是肘部。过几天你跟我们一起上班，就是。
Learning these basic medical skills was just a window to their world. They, on average, would receive 30 patients per day, but I definitely think that their challenges come from other places. The nature of their job is different. They live in hard environment. You know, we're speaking mountains, we're speaking highlands. That brings its own sets of challenges to the doctors.
This hospital, in the alpine project, has what role?
The role is the most basic, is to 给村民检查那个健康知识，给他们进行签约那个家庭医生签约，去家里面进行义诊，给他们一些最基础的体检，还有慢病，每个季度做一次随访。65岁以上老年人他们行动也不便，我们医院的角色就是去入户，给他一些最基本的检查。
Today we're going up the mountains to check up on the health situation of the villagers up in the mountain. We're bringing a lot of stuff with us. This is an annual checkup that they do. Because the villagers cannot come down, we're going to go up with them, moving the whole hospital, in a sense, all the way up. That's the last point the car can reach, and now we have to work our feet climbing up to the village.
Okay.
Because of the rain, and the rain is getting a little bit stronger, the ground is wet and slippery. So we really have to keep our balance. Quiet, 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 quiet. Officially tired. Hiyo, Iban. Hi. How kapa?
2000多,
if I say it was a tough trek, that would be an understatement. It was immensely hard to get to them. It was raining nonstop. Imagine just like wading through mud, wading through, you know, just mud on a slippery slope, and you're climbing with no equipment. If anything, you had on your back in baskets because we needed to get some machines up so we can do our jobs. It was just too much, but we had to do it because these people were living all the way up in the mountain, really cut off from the rest of the world, cut off from any medical facility. If China wants its population to be healthy, it's an essential thing to be done. We made it. We can see the fern signs, first signs of life. We made it, the first house, in over an hour. And we see an old lady tending to the field. So this is the entrance to the village, I'm assuming. Luckily, we all made it alive.
This is their 那个木屋的环境，没有电，就靠这个火炉供暖，所以到处都要通风。我们要做的东西呢，就是给老人家做常规的血压、血糖、心肺的听诊、腹部的触诊，还有看看他的基本情况。很多在山区里面，他都有风湿病或者关节病。So
we're visiting the first house here, and it's all made of wood. Basically, Dr. He is telling me that what we are doing is just a basic medical checkup, and there is just no electricity here. They're just using the wood for heating and for a bit of light. So that's their life, a very simple one. Because of the bad weather, we decided to move the health checkup indoors. We were supposed to do it out in the open. This is completely hectic. Everyone's just working together. You have the EKG station there. You have the blood pressure and blood sugar level station here. She's filling out the forms. Everything, everyone has something to do. So far we're just waiting until first patient finishes with his EKG, so we get to rest for a while.
before things get hectic again.
他们一般，我们上来给他体检，他基本上他们也不下去。现在呢，是道路已经很好，如果以前的话，我们刚才来的时候，那条泥路都是泥路的。嗯，我们基本上一走个从这里到我们的卫生院，基本上他们可能花一天走就不来。哎呦，那个，那就水银的。放一遍。走。
It seems that this gentleman's blood pressure is too high. The machine cannot even read it. So we have to go back to the good old-fashioned way of measuring his blood pressure.
再测一测。210。有测过血压高吗？
有测过血压高，平常高的血压的时候，一般是在什么范围内？有医生叫你吃药吗？医生你咋被来不行？咋的？哦，吃的时候不吃药，我药都不药，可吗？药你都不要。说过，但是他没去药。我经常都没有下可吗？干嘛不要呢？让你长期说长期血压在200左右的话，可能你中风的可能性会增加。所以说血压高的时候，我们要把血压控制下来。那你控制下来就必须要什么？
一个药行为干预，一个是药物干预。你能听懂我说什么？听得懂，听得懂啊。那你现在准备开始吃药了没有？准备吃了。准备吃吧。啊，那我们现在送一盒药给你，好吧？然后你吃完之后经常去量血压，记着啊，医生不叫你停，你就按时间吃。When
you think of doctors, you always think of like this noble mission to treat and save lives. They surely really exemplify that idea of what a doctor is. They're packing their stuff, they're going up the mountain, check up on people and make sure that they're healthy or to try to even detect some underlying problems. And they're doing it with a humane approach. They were willing to accommodate any questions that these villagers had. They really exemplified, you know, that ideal image that we have about doctors, like angels in white.
他有没有说他有什么基础病，或者说我让我们看的是什么病？没有说，就是这个。他有声音。看他会有。老师，啊，你过来看一下这个，他有个伤口。这个伤口，我觉得就是有点。碘伏酒精，我们现场做一次消毒吧。 我们，但是我们只有酒精是吧？有碘伏，碘伏酒精都有是不是？手慢慢拉开，电动一大。这些都是他些烂皮肤在里面的，我都有点怀疑他是不是拿那些泥沙盖在上去。痛是吧？你跟他拿不拿？跟他说。
那么呢？还不拿？ 它最坏的结果不是截肢，它最坏的结果它这个烂到骨膜去，会形成什么？骨膜炎、骨髓炎，骨髓炎的话，它可能会引起毒血症、败血症，然后引起生命危险。
The guy was just moaning, but moaning in silence. He was extremely patient and gentle. I'm sure that he was under so much pain, but he didn't at all express it. We tried to speak to his son about why is it that he didn't take his old man to the hospital. I was extremely shocked and disappointed by the answer of the son when he said he didn't think there was a need. In communities like that, they're living high up on the mountain, really secluded. People would actually, if they were sick, they would just wait it out, or they would just brush it off. And the graphic imagery of what I saw, it just made me realize how difficult and how tough this situation is like.
In this situation, 一个是我们的宣传可能做得不够，一个呢也是因为这个这里的环境的问题，道路不好，然后呢经济问题啊，包括要工作啊，年轻人要工作啊，我们还是要通过后面大力的就说宣传，啊，要告知他的预后，告知他，然后对他们有个卫生的宣教，卫生知识的培养高了，素质高了，他会才慢慢有正义的这种想法。
Nature could be a barrier for them to get access to medical help. That is a fact. But nature toughens them. It makes them more tough, more resilient. And that really translates into the way they perceive, perhaps, their health status. If they accept death as a natural life process, then they understand that life, whenever there's life, there's death, and then death breeds life. They're in tune with the natural laws, and then in nature, there's birth, and then there's death. Another day, another flight of stairs that we're climbing. It's not easy being a village doctor.
Uh-huh. 都是免费的。 谢了。
就妈妈的，一个是 baby 的。我们做完之后，就正常就 OK 了。
好。
刚好了，满月请我喝酒，是吧？
如果他们住在这里，他们生病的时候是随便会去卫生院，但是他们住在
山上，
对，
就基本上就很难去卫生院，
对，
太远了，下来不方便。我们昨天花了两个多小时上去，然后又花两个多小时下来，一天就花了五个小时在这个路上。
对。
好吃吗？它有点感觉像那田气的那种。
好了，这个多少个？你要看看。媳妇，你给住过院个呀？
我们的那个家庭医生，就是每个千户的话，就有个服务手册。他的出院诊断呢，就是一个直肠癌手术，然后呢，结肠和慢肠多发性息肉。脱个鞋，对，我们平躺下来。
要痛吗？痛吗？
都没有，对吧？OK。病人的腹部是非常良好。你有什么想问他的吗？
从发现有这个病到现在，你花了多少钱？
刚刚做手术的时候是38000多，
做了六次化疗。
第一次去化疗是用了10000多，但是报销回来是还是一半的。医疗费的话就没花多少，就是来来回回这些吃的喝的都花了很多钱。
他是在大理做的化疗，他是州外。州外的报销，医疗报销是70%左右。还有一些隐形的账目，比如说在坐车的、住宿的，不能报销的。
那你们的卫生院会不会治这样的病？
通常现在是治不了，所以说他是，
所以没办法，
没办法，只能是往外走去了。要理解这里的历史，大理的环境跟贡山的环境不一样。虽然他们很努力，但是他们也是从就等于是打地基一样，从一块砖一块砖的叠起来的，但是叠的时间不如大理叠的这么扎实，叠的这么长久。贡山的医疗这几年也在上涨，他们都在积极的培养人才，像我们班府的都过来帮助他们嘛。我们就是这其实就是我们来的意义嘛。
The woman had cancer, and between surgery, treatment cycles, and travel costs, the family paid over 170,000 yuan. They were reimbursed around 100,000 thanks to health insurance. Dr. He says things could have been a lot worse without the insurance. I believe him. Diseases are costly, and the family's case is an example of how ill health and poverty are related, and how essential healthcare policies in place are.
贫困意味着他可能得到的医疗资源会比较少，生病大病可能意味着他会更加贫困。所以无论是哪一种状态，我们觉得我们都应该做医疗扶贫。他一开始是属于一个相对封闭的峡谷，然后面对大城市，面对世界的机会都不多，所以说信息化还有资源化它肯定是比较短缺的。要改变的话就必须要几代人去改变，不可能说政府投入了几个亿或者十几个亿一下子把资金推上去了，你就可以立刻得到一个三甲或者说得到一个很好的医疗资源，我觉得这个都是不可能的，需要不断的去培养，不断的合理的去分配。至于你说山区的生活很苦，其实我觉得也不苦啊，就只是有点，最多就是有点想家而已。
There's a party outside. So what's happening outside is that every week they would have a market, and it seems that someone is feeling in the party mood quite early in the morning. So I don't know how this will interfere with our daily.Work, but I guess it is what it is. It's quite funny though.
Mm. 买菜的话就是周一的时候一次在这边买、啊、购买以后就一周、啊、一周的伙食就是今天全部备好、啊、然后我们就装在冰箱里然后就储存一个周的、
啊、They do their shopping once a week on Monday when the market starts
这边就是、老百姓买了以后回家就自己 养殖的
So for people here, this is their only chance to buy stuff without having to travel for long distances. And so they really make use of this opportunity every week.
So by 10, this whole market should be fully set up and then people will start coming and then they will pass by the hospital.
Medical checkup, free medicine, free information about diseases. Come. 免费药，免费药，来，免费信息。
现在由我们这个何老师跟大家说哈，怎样就是用药的？你们用药方面要注意些什么？
平常有没有胃病的？胃病的，平常你们有没有吃过胃药？那我们胃病的话，多数来说吃胃药是在什么时候吃胃药？
饭前。
饭前，对，就说差不多吃饭之前，饭前半个小时左右吃胃药。
看病门诊可以报多少我还不知道。来我们县里面的话来我们乡诊卫生员，就是说报可以报95%，就是说你100块的钱，你就要开5块钱就可以了。然后到县里面住院的话，你那个可以报90%，然后就是100块里面你就要开10块钱。然后到州里面住院是80%，然后到那个州外就大理啊、昆明这些的话可以报70%，这样吧。
So the workshop is over.We went over a lot of health information, some basic health information. We've given them this pamphlet, 66 points to keep healthy. For example, not drinking a lot of alcohol if you have high blood pressure or not even drinking a lot of alcohol in general. And then gradually we went up in terms of difficult or like more complicated medical knowledge. For example, in terms of blood pressure, what is the range? We've also spoken about COVID, and they've given them this medical advice of whenever they need to cough or whenever they need to sneeze, they should cover their mouth instead of just coughing or spitting out in the open. The attitudes of locals in Gongshan towards healthcare have been shaped by their environment. For the longest time, doctors were not an option, so they made do without doctors. Living in nature has also toughened them, and many have developed high tolerance to health problems. But illness and poverty are extremely intertwined, and ill health is a burden on those who can barely keep their head above water.Medical services are no longer as inaccessible as before, despite having a long way to go. But with the devotion, professionalism, and patience of doctors here, villagers are in safe hands.
It's time to give back the white coat.
谢谢你。辛苦了。
你也辛苦。哎，大家，谢谢你们这3-4天跟我分享你们的生活和工作。我看你们每一天都在努力工作，认真
父母老百姓保护他们的健康。我觉得虽然资源很少，但是你们做很多，真的你们的职业道德让我很感动，大家辛苦了，真的辛苦。我的心现在不不不不不不不，
就共处了三四天，我们一起去山上下乡看病，你表现的都不错。
谢谢。
也欢迎下次，期待有下次。
如果有机会，肯定我会来。
欢迎再来高丽工商。
谢谢你们，谢谢。
好，没问题，没问题。可以可以。好，大家拜拜，加油！
拜拜。
拜拜。